Here is how I became a UX designer in 3 weeks.
I took 25 UX design course and certification available in the internet. Google certification, Coursera, free bootcamps, and countless number of YouTube videos. They all taught me the same thing, how to use Figma. Did not understand shit about design. Read all the design blog 10 times. Practice how to design a login screen in 5 different software. Figma, XD, Sketch, went to the font, Google font, memorize all the font names.
The Garamond way.
Red Hook, didn't understand shit. Red Energy, didn't understand shit, but memorize all the terms. IA, user flow, card shorting. Shit, I'm so intelligent. Prepared my resume, added all the fancy keyword possible. Research, prototype, customer experience. Applied the same in multiple companies in LinkedIn. Made a few random posts on which UI is better. Got a design interview. Drank a lot of coffee for no reason. Fucking love the high. The guy is calling me for the interview. I open ChatGPT in my side laptop. I'm ready.
I personally don't know that if anyone can become a UX designer in 3 months or 3 weeks or not. Because the learning good design is a lifelong process. But to get into the industry, you must have at least few basic design knowledge clear. So this is the learning path I wish I had followed when I started my design career. I'm creating this video with intention to helping anyone become a well-rounded product designer. I did not attend any course or bootcamps while learning UX design. Instead, I learned mostly from my mentors and my colleagues in work. So regularly I get these DMs on my Instagram which says, hi, I'm working as an engineer for 5 years and wanted to switch to UX. How should I start? We'll discuss in this video, should I go to design college to learn design? If you have the resources, you should go. Hi, I'm an architect and want to switch to UX design. How can I do that? It's actually very easy for architects and graphic designers. We'll discuss that part in the video too. Also today, right today I got this email. Let me show you guys. Hey, hope you have a great weekend. So I joined bootcamp of UX UI design from Karnataka for 4 months. Now I finished my course. Feel like I'm very much weak in UX part and feel so much lack of confidence. Yeah, I can understand where this person is coming from because most of the bootcamps, they teach you how to use Figma. They don't really teach you how to, you know, design anything good. Yeah, I can understand where this person coming from. So almost every day I get this kind of DMs and email. So I thought of answering all of these queries in one video itself. So first of all, you guys should know that cream gets on top. If you guys pour cream on a coffee or a tea, eventually it rises to the top. So if you are a good designer, it will also happen to you. So you need to have that much amount of patience inside you. There is no shortcut to success. You have to put in the hard work, but where to put the hard work becomes more important if you are learning UX. Hey everyone, I'm a designer currently working with Microsoft, and for the past 7+ years I have been designing app. Previously also worked with Flipkart, Scoop, and Lollipop. I come from a tier 3 college in India and still I managed to work with few of the best brands in the world, establishing credibility. So if my 2 laptops and my collection of books which I never read didn't help you to establish the credibility, this line should. Anyway, let's move on. So first of all, you should understand, should you switch to UX? If you're getting into UX because someone has told you that you are going to make a lot of money, you should avoid getting into UX. Because just like any other field in design, there are people in UX who is making a median salary or a basic salary, and there are people in UX who are making a really good salary. It really depends upon your skill set that you have. I know a lot of graphic designers who makes millions and a lot of UX designers who makes really the basic salaries. So try to avoid getting into UX just because someone has told you that, hey, you can make a lot of money in this, because that's not the case. So you should try to understand the roles and responsibility before getting into UX. In UX design, a company or a client hires you to solve a problem related to their digital product. And it involves understanding the user flow, information architect, team wireframes, final screens, and finally shipping it to the developers and later testing out those designs with the real customers and improve on them. So shipping a product in a UX design is a very long process, and you need to understand and enjoy each and every part of the journey. So first of all, let's understand who can switch. If you are coming from any design field like graphic design or architect or even engineer, it's very easy for you to break into UX because UX design is solving problem in a beautiful way. Now you should notice that I have used the word beautiful because engineers also solve problems, but if you're a UX designer, you need to solve the problem keeping in mind the customer pain point and aesthetics in mind. So if you're an engineer, architect, or even a PM, everyone who have the knack of solving problem, I think they can get into UX. Especially for graphic designer and architect, I feel it's really easy for them to get into UX because you guys are already doing a lot of things that a UX designers do. Like, let's understand this by an example. Like, if a client comes to you and asks you, suppose you're a graphic designer and a client comes to you and asks you, hey, can you please design a brand identity for us? So before designing the logo, what you're going to do, you're going to research on the client. You're going to understand that is the client, the product is in a digital space or in a physical space. You need to understand the target audience of the clients. And based on all of that, you are going to design a logo. Now, you're not just designing a symbol for one particular surface. You're going to design the logo for all the surface, like for website, to a mobile app, to a print surface, to a fab icon, and all of those. So this exact step in UX is known as scalability. And in UX, scalability has a huge role. So I'll get to that after some time. Step one, what do you need to learn? Now that's the $1 million question, right? What do you need to learn to get into UX? To be a UX designer, you need to understand the problem and try to find a solution for it. For this, you need to learn at least these 5 basic things. First is knowledge gatherings. So this is the first step to understand a given problem. If you're working with a freelance client, in this step, we generally send a questionnaire to understand their requirement and understand what the client are actually trying to solve. So this is the step where you actually need to understand what you're trying to solve and the entire scope of the work. This step usually involves intense research. Second is information architect. So good knowledge of information architect is what differentiates between a really good UX designer and an amateur UX designer. So if you guys want to make your career in UX design, so I would suggest to learn how to create information architect in a very thorough way, because understanding information architect is very, very important. So information architect focuses on organizing the information within digital or physical products. You might have seen in few of my previous videos that whenever I'm starting a project, I generally start the project with the IA. There is something called cart sorting. We use this method with customers or client to figure out what the exact IA of the product should be. If you guys want me to make tutorials on information architect, please let me know in the comments below. Now, once the IA is done, I generally start with the visual design. For visual design, you need to learn at least these 3 things, typography, color, grids, and layout. All of these are important, but among this, typography is the most important thing in visual design. It is something that can make or break your design. So learn typography as best as you can. Once you learn this 3 basic steps, there are also things like sound design, motion design, shipping it to the developers, but you don't need to learn this to get into the industry right now. While continuing your UX career, I think you should actually learn these skills. If you want me to make videos on sound design and motion design in UX, please let me know in the comments below. Fourth is prototyping. Prototyping kind of become important skill currently in the industry, mostly because prototyping capabilities are right now integrated directly in the design softwares. It is not a difficult skill to learn, and it's always helpful to prototype your design while you're presenting client or showing it for a customer research. Fifth is learning the UX terms. Imagine you are in a room full of designers where they're talking about design. If you don't understand the terminologies what they're using, you will not be able to participate in the conversation. It is very important to learn at least few basic UX terms. You don't need to learn all the terms, but knowing at least few basic terms will definitely help you. So this 5 are the design process that you need to know. The next is how to sell your design. Being a designer is not only about making design, but it's also about learning how to sell your design to your clients and your stakeholders. Learning how to design and sell it is a very important skill, and it takes time to build it. Eventually, if you talk to a lot of clients, this skill will eventually grow. So while presenting the design, you will get a lot of feedback from the clients, and being open to that feedback is a very important job. Understanding client feedback, understanding why they are giving you the feedback and what feedback you need to take and what feedback you need to push back on is a very important skill as a UX designer. The next step is creating UX case study. Once you're done with your design, you should document your work and present it in a format of a UX case study. I have made an entire video on how to create UX case study, so the link is in the description. If you're a beginner and you don't have any client projects, you can take up any hypothetical problem and find a solution for that. and try to show your problem solving abilities. Step 4 is building your portfolio. Once you have 2 to 3 case studies, you can start building your portfolio. I have already made an entire video on this channel of how to create your UX portfolio. Instead of building a website, you can also choose to present your work in Behance, Medium, or any other no-code tool of your choice. The idea at this stage is to publish your work so that your potential client or design recruiter can find you on the internet. Step 5 is finding a mentor. So most of my learning happened from my mentors in job and colleagues. In fact, in my first job, I found my design mentor Vineet. He was my manager back then, and till now we are very close, and till now he is one of my design mentors. Not only Vineet, in every job, most of my senior managers kind of became my mentors. Now, asking someone randomly for mentorship doesn't work. You need to build up and cultivate the relationship. For me, relationship with my mentors and some colleagues goes beyond my work. First, they are my really good friends, and then they kind of became my mentors. So getting a mentor is not a work thing. It's more about cultivating that relationship with someone. And ultimately, feedback from your peers and friends will help you to become a better designer. But if you're new to design industry and you don't have any contacts, you can go to this website called ADP List. There you will find people from various design backgrounds, and they offer mentorship. Once you're done with your UX portfolio and UX case studies, you need to start preparing your resume and apply for jobs. In this step, you need to start reaching out to your clients or recruiters of different companies who are hiring, and also apply your portfolio for the same. You can also check out different job boards like LinkedIn, and check which companies are hiring and apply in all those places. If you want to go to the freelance route, that is also possible. You can start to reach out to your potential clients and apply your portfolio. In my personal experience, the best way to get into design industry is through an agency. Starting off my career, I actually worked on an agency, and I thoroughly enjoyed my entire time over there. Because in an agency, you will be working with more than 50 to 70 plus designers depending on the size of the agency, and you get to work with different clients, so that will also improve your soft skills. So I want to end this video with one thought, that learn design and not softwares. I hope this video has helped you, and yes, I've been making this new style of video, and let me know your thoughts on the comments. Also, thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in the next one.